हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज बिंदी पटेल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट माइंड एंड बॉडी इंटरवेंशन। सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद अवर टॉपिक, दैट इज माइंड बॉडी इंटरवेंशन। इट इज वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एंड ऑल्टरनेटिव मेडिसिन थेरेपी। माइंड बॉडी मेडिसिन यूजेज अ वैरायटी ऑफ टेक्निक्स डिजाइन टू एनहेंस द माइंड कैपेसिटी टू अफेक्ट बॉडीली फंक्शन एंड सिम्टम्स। ओके, सो द मेन गोल ऑफ दिस थेरेपी इज टू इंक्रीज द कैपेसिटी ऑफ माइंड। Some techniques that were considered alternative in the past have become mainstream, for example patient support group and cognitive behavioral therapy. We will see in one by one. So first is patient support group. It is a group of people with common experiences and concerns who provide emotional and moral support for one another. So it is a group in which the people who are having the same problem, they are getting together and discussing their problems and experiences. By that way, they are getting the emotional and moral support for each other. The support group fulfill many functions like educating patients and family, sharing their illness and experience, and providing strength to its members and raising the public awareness. So this is all the functions of patient support group. Now second is cognitive behavioral therapy. It is a talking therapy that can help you manage your problem by changing the way you think and behave. So in this, the patient are getting change their attitude towards the disease or towards their problem, and they will think positively that they will come out of all the problem easily and very soon. So this is called the cognitive behavioral therapy. Now next we'll see about the types of mind and body interventions. In that, first is meditation and breathing. Second is relaxation. Third is hypnosis. Fourth is biofeedback. So this is all types of mind and body interventions. So first we'll see about the meditation and breathing. Meditation means sitting or resting quietly, often with the closed eye, which still the mind for greater self-awareness. In meditation, we are sitting quietly with the quiet place and with the closed eye, which still the mind means, which calms our mind and will get the greater self-awareness in our body. Then meditation also helps in reduction of pain and relieving the stress. So it is also helping in the pain reduction and relieving the stress. Then it also involves sometimes the repetitive sound of mantra like the Om, okay, then which helps the person to focus in the meditation. Meditation promotes the relaxation, okay. It also promoting the relaxation and we can gain the greater self-awareness by this. Now what are the components of meditation? So first is quiet space, okay. It is require quiet space and comfortable positions will be there, a respective attitude, okay, then a focus of attention. So this is all things required for having the meditation. Now techniques of meditation. So first is meditation and rhythmic breathing. Second is progressive relaxation. Third is relaxation by sensory pacing. And fourth is relaxing with music. Okay. So first is meditation and rhythmic breathing. In this, provide a quiet environment. So we should give the proper and quiet environment to the client. Then help the client to get comfortable while seated or lying on bed. So we should provide comfortable position to the client. Then instruct the client to close eyes and hold a receptive attitude. Means we should instruct the client to close the eyes and receptive attitude means he or she should be focused on the meditation. Instruct the client to breathe in and out slowly and deeply using the abdominal muscle, keeping the chest still. So we should instruct the client to do the breathing in and out slowly by breathing the deeply abdominal muscle and keeping the chest still, okay. So at the beginning of every out-breath, have client to repeat the number 1 silently in his or her mind and continue for period of meditation. So we should ask the client to repeat the number 1 silently in his or her mind at every breath out in the period of meditation. Explain that when the mind wanders, bring it back to counting the out breath without judgment. So whenever the person's mind go in the wander means the mind engage in the thoughts, okay, that person is not conscious about their mind, what his or her mind thinking. It is called the mind wander. हैव अ क्लाइंट प्रैक्टिस फॉर 5, 10, 15 or 20 minutes पर सेशन. प्रैक्टिस डेली फॉर एटलीस्ट वन सेशन. ओके, सो एटलीस्ट वन सेशन शुड बी पर्सन शुड प्रैक्टिस डेली. सो नाउ सेकंड इज प्रोग्रेसिव रिलैक्सेशन. इन दिस फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स 1, 2, 3 and 4 ऑफ मेडिटेशन एंड रिदमिक ब्रीथिंग. सो इन दिस द पर्सन शुड फॉलो द स्टेप्स ऑफ मेडिटेशन 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड रिदमिक ब्रीथिंग शुड डू. वंस द क्लाइंट इज ब्रीथिंग स्लोली एंड कम्फर्टेबली इंस्ट्रक्ट द क्लाइंट टू टाइटन एंड रिलैक्स द मसल्स. सो वेन द क्लाइंट कम्फर्टेबल विथ द मेडिटेशन एंड विथ द ब्रीथिंग स्लोली एंड कम्फर्टेबली देन यू शुड इंस्ट्रक्ट द क्लाइंट टू टाइटन द मसल्स एंड रिलैक्सिंग द मसल्स साइमल्टेनियसली. देन इंस्ट्रक्ट द क्लाइंट टू टेंस एंड रिलैक्स द काल्व्स एंड नीज ऑफ द बॉडी. सो थर्ड इज रिलैक्सेशन बाय सेंसरी पेसिंग. इन दैट ऑल्सो वी आर डूइंग द फॉलोइंग स्टेप 1, 2, 3 and 4 ऑफ मेडिटेशन एंड रिदमिक ब्रीथिंग. इंस्ट्रक्ट द क्लाइंट टू स्लोली रिपीट एंड फिनिश आइदर इन अ लो वॉइस ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंस. नाउ आई एम अवेयर ऑफ सीइंग, नाउ आई एम अवेयर ऑफ फीलिंग, नाउ आई एम अवेयर ऑफ हियरिंग. सो इंस्ट्रक्ट द क्लाइंट टू रिपीट एंड कम्प्लीट ईच सेंटेंस 4 times, देन 3 times, देन 2 times एंड फाइनली 1. सो इट इज फॉर द सेंसरी पेसिंग रिलैक्सेशन टेक्निक. Now fourth is relaxing with music. In this first is provide client with a tape recorder and headset. Second is ask client to select a favorite cassette of slow quiet music. Instruct the client to get into a comfortable position and to close eyes and listen the music through headset. And fourth one is instruct the client to imagine floating with music. So in this we are providing the headset or tape recorder to the client and we are asking them to select their favorite music and we are providing them comfortable position with closed eyes and they will listen the music with a headset and we'll ask them to imagine their music which are with their listening. Okay, so now we'll see about the clinical application. In that first is prolonging life expectancy, means it increases the patient's life span and stress control, pain management, cancer and other chronic illnesses, heart disease, high blood pressure, infertility, psoriasis, respiratory crisis, premenstrual syndrome, tension headache, irritable bowel syndrome, ulcer and insomnia and fibromyalgia. So this is all the clinical condition in which we can give the meditation and breathing technique to the person. So now we'll see about the limitation of meditation. It may be contraindicated in the people who have a strong fear of losing control. Okay, so the person who has a strong fear, then we can give the meditation to the person. Then hypertensive individual require much shorter session than average 15 to 20 minutes session. Okay, so people who are having the hypertensive problem, then we should give only 15 to 20 minutes session only. Okay. So now we see the second type of the mind-body intervention, that is relaxation. Relaxation techniques are aimed at relaxing muscles and quieting the mind and are mainly designed to relieve tension and strain. So the main goal of the relaxation technique is to relaxing the muscle and making the mind calm and relieving the tension and strain of the body. It is also used as an alternative treatment for insomnia. Okay, so we can use it for insomnia also. Insomnia means the lacking of sleep. Okay, patient can't sleep. So now we'll see about the characteristics of relaxation. So it is decrease the heart rate, decrease the respiratory rate, decrease the blood pressure and also decrease the oxygen consumption of the body. Now we'll see clinical application of relaxation therapy. When we can give relaxation therapy to the person, so to lowering the heart rate, to lowering the BP, tension, improving the well-being of the person, reducing symptoms of distress, and it in the depression and in anxiety also we can give relaxation therapy. So now we'll see about the third type of the mind and body intervention, that is hypnosis. Hypnosis is a sort of conscious sleep or trance that can help people deal with addiction, pain or anxiety disorders. So in this patient is in their subconscious state, then it helps the patient in pain, addiction and anxiety disorder. In hypnosis, a person is put into an advanced state of relaxation in which he is relatively unaware of his surroundings but not entirely unconscious about it. So in this, patient is in subconscious state, not fully unconscious or not fully conscious. Okay, hypnotized person follows the instruction of given by the hypnotherapist and tends not to be too psychological stress and conflict. So in this, hypnotized person is following the instruction of hypnotherapist. Okay. So now we'll see about the indications for hypnosis. So habit disorders, relaxation, anxiety stress, OCD means obsession and compulsive disorder, and psychotic disorder. So when patient is having any kind of the addiction or any kind of the anxiety disorder, then we can use this hypnosis therapy. Then contraindication for hypnosis, when in a patient who does not want it, okay, the patient is refusing to take the hypnosis therapy, then hypertensive individual, the person who are having the hypertensive disease, then we can give the hypnosis. So now we'll see about the fourth type of the mind and body intervention, that is biofeedback. So biofeedback is a group of therapeutic procedures that use electronic or electromechanical instrument to measure the process and information to person about their neuromuscular and autonomic nervous system. So in biofeedback, we are using the electromechanical instrument to measure the information about the person and the neuromuscular and autonomic nervous system. The information of biofeedback is given in physical, physiological activity or visual feedback signals. People are trained to exercise some control over the way their bodies work and involve measuring the subject bodily process such as blood pressure, heart rate, skin temperature using the electronic sensor. So in this way, measuring the patient's blood pressure, heart rate, skin temperature, okay? And biofeedback help a person to be more aware of what his body is doing and to bring reaction under control, okay? So we can know, we can measure the vital signs of the patient, and moreover, we can control their vital signs also. Now we'll see the most common biofeedback techniques are: first is temperature biofeedback, second is EMG biofeedback, third is EEG biofeedback, and fourth is galvanic skin response. Okay, so this is all four techniques of the biofeedback. We'll see one by one. So now we'll see about the first technique, that is temperature biofeedback. It is usually to train the individual to be able to increase or decrease the temperature of their hands or feet at will and gain increased control of this aspect of autonomic nervous system functioning. Okay, so the person by himself, they can increase or decrease the temperature of hands and feet. So now we'll see about the second technique, that is electromyography. It is an electrodiagnostic medicine technique for evaluating and recording the electrical activity produced by skeletal muscles of the body. EMG is performed using an instrument called an electromyograph to produce a record called an electromyogram. Okay, so whichever record is produced by electromyograph, it is called electromyogram. So now we'll see about the third technique, that is EEG biofeedback, a treatment being studied to improve brain function in a certain brain disorder and patients treated with chemotherapy for breast cancer. So this therapy is very much useful in patients with brain disorder. Sensors are placed on the person's head, which allows the brain activity to be shown as pattern on a computer screen. So we are placing the sensor on person's head, and whichever activity occurs in brain, we can see on the computer screen. Now fourth technique is galvanic skin response. A change in the electrical resistance of the skin caused by emotional stress measurable with a sensitive galvanometer. It is called the galvanic skin response. For example, lie detector test. Okay, so whenever patient is testing by this lie detector test, the person, if person will get lie, then person will be worried about inside. Okay, so that can measure by this galvanometer. Okay. Now clinical application of biofeedback. When we can give this biofeedback therapy? So in pain, then in relieving the stress, whenever patient is having the insomnia and headache. Okay. Now we'll see about the limitations of biofeedback. During the relaxation, the feeling may be uncovered that client cannot cope with them. For this reason, it's recommended that प्रैक्टिशनर शुड बी ट्रेन. ओके, सो विदाउट ट्रेनिंग वी कैन परफॉर्म दिस बायोफीडबैक ट्रीटमेंट. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द बायोफीडबैक. सो हियर वी आर कंक्लूडिंग अवर टॉपिक. बिफोर एंडिंग द सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू, इफ यू लाइक माई वीडियो प्लीज लाइक इट, शेयर इट एंड सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल. स्टे सेफ, स्टे एट होम ओनली. बाय, थैंक यू.